bass players, musicians, welcome. We are getting towards the end of the year. I have one more musical job in the books this year. I'm leaving in a few days to go make a record with Steve Smith, with the drummer Steve Smith and his band Vital Information. We get to spend a very luxurious 5 days in the studio in New York. And with everything that's been going on recently, I've been really kind of short on practice time. So I want to share something with you, and I'm going to kind of challenge you to try and commit to this. See if you can do it for a week, 2 weeks, maybe even a month of doing this every single day. It's what I'm using this week to get my chops back in shape. It's been a while since I was on the road. It's been a while since I was playing every night. It's been a while since those calluses on my picking hand were sort of rock hard and in tip-top premium shape. And I'm basically combining two exercises I've been using forever, since the very beginning, kind of Hannon virtuoso pianist style exercises. One is descending, here in F major. It's just a four note, a groupings of four notes within a major scale. And the other is a very similar pattern, but ascending. I've kind of come down the scale, and then I'm going to play a 2-octave arpeggio. So we go from the root up 2 octaves, up the arpeggio, and we land on this new note, this F. It's the root of the key we've just been in. That starts the cycle of fourths, because we now, if we start on that note, the same pattern. Now we're in B flat, and when we end the B flat, we're on a cycle of fourths. We go to E flat. So that's the pattern. Cycle of fourths, 2 major shapes, 1 descending. Hi guys, pardon the interruption. As you well know by now, this channel doesn't have huge sponsors like the Cash App or Manscaped. So I'm going to take 30 seconds of your time and use it to promote our Black Friday sale, which is happening right now through midnight on Monday. The entire library, for the first time, all the books I've ever written are bundled up in one big bundle. It's 16 or 17 books, and they are 50% off. That is at janekgwizdala.com. And if you already have some of these books and you don't need the entire library, you can get 22% off any bundle, any individual book, and also any of my albums that are also at the website now, or the HX Stomp preset packages using the coupon code GETBASE22. All the information is at janekgwizdala.com. I've also gone absolutely bonkers with adding new videos and new content to Janek's Bass Studio this month. I've uploaded, I think it's just over 170 new videos, including transcriptions, live concerts, all kinds of stuff. That is at janekbassstudio.com. You can get over $350 off a lifetime membership, or 35% off all courses at the site. All the information is linked below in the description of this video. And now let's get back to the show. 2 major shapes, 1 descending, 1 ascending. You start on the 5th degree of the key center that you're in. So I was starting key center F major, so starting on C. And you skip a diatonic, the first interval is a third. And it's diatonic to the key, so sometimes it's a minor third, sometimes it's a major third. Exactly the same thing going up. Sometimes it's a major third, sometimes it's a minor third, but the first interval is always a third. I put that little phrase on the end. 2-octave arpeggio. That's it. That's the shape. It's very simple. You can pause and rewind, go back and look over this and get it under your fingers. It's nothing you can't do. If you can play a major scale, you can absolutely do this. You don't need your bass strung with a high C. You don't even need 5 strings on it. We could go in 4-string range. Ah. Etc. etc., etc. It doesn't matter how your bass is strung or what register you're playing in. This is available to everyone. It's actually available to any instrument as well. But fretted stringed instruments, really easy to visualize that, at least have the visual reference from the video. And it's what I'm using every day. I can get through all 12 keys in less than 5 minutes at a kind of medium tempo. And that really sets me up with some consistency, with some warmth, with some blood flow in the fingers. I challenge you to do that. If you are having any technical issues, take it way slow. If you're having any consistency issues, this could be something that really helps kickstart you into a better place, into a place of more confidence in your playing, into a place of feeling like, wow, what do I, if you have that question, I know we all have that question sometimes, what do I practice? What should I work on? How about something that's just fundamental to your instrument? Of course, don't forget about time and sound while you do this. Those are absolutely critical in terms of getting the most out of this. It's not just about chops or technique or speed or any of that. It's really about time and sound blended with the consistency of doing that. First of all, in the moment, in the day, in that moment of the day that you have to practice, and doing it through 12 keys. Maybe you only have 5 or 10 minutes. Just do this for 5 or 10 minutes. And then really it's about the consistency of doing that over and over and over again, day after day after day after day. I'm sure if you've watched any of my videos, you've heard me say before, it's so much more valuable to, you know, if your time is limited, to practice a little bit, but do it every day rather than practicing 8 hours on a Monday and then not touching your bass until Friday or Saturday. Do it every day. Have that sense of routine. Have that sense of, you know, make creating good habits for yourself when it comes to spending time with the instrument. And already I'm moving into, you know, different sort of iterations of that same sound. That's sort of the next step, the next, you know, I start to hear music then. And I'm always trying to be musical. It's not like this is just completely mechanical and I can like watch a movie or be distracted somewhere else and just let this run in the background. I'm really concentrating on the tone production. In some places I really want to be completely even and make every note exactly the same, but I also want the ability to have shape in it as well, to really want to have that control. And when you're playing something that's quite simple, it's diatonic, it's just based around a major scale, that sort of takes a little bit of the thought process out of it, I hope. But again, work on it slowly first, get it under your fingers. They're two very simple shapes. Conceptually, it's quite simple. Just remember, like, if you can play a major scale, you can absolutely do this. Don't sell yourself short. Don't say, well, that's a little bit fast, or I don't quite understand what's going on. I've given you a really solid explanation of exactly what the two shapes are, how I'm using them around the neck. Use the pause, use the rewind, scan back along if you're not getting something. Go over it and over it and over it. Use your ear. You know, I'm always reluctant to just give the tab or the sheet music the quick way out, the easy fix, I'll just look at somebody else's work rather than doing it myself. If you, you know, somewhat transcribe what I'm doing from this video, it is going to stick with you so much deeper than if you just read it in a book, or you read it from a PDF, from a tab, or from some sheet music. So, you know, don't sell yourself short on what you are capable of, because you are capable of great things, number one, and working out a shape in, you know, diatonic major shape. I have high confidence that everyone watching this is absolutely capable of doing that. And then it's a question of exploring. You know, obviously this isn't the only thing I'm doing to get ready for these recording sessions with Steve next week. I have to learn the music, and I have to make sure I'm repeating that music and that it's sort of ingrained in my playing, so I'm not thinking about it and hopefully not reading it either. You know, it's nice to have the ability to walk into the studio and to read stuff like that. But when it comes to, you know, when I do have some time, when I know I'm a week out and I have some music already, when I have that time, it's really nice to use it to learn the material. So I'm way more relaxed and I can pay attention to what's going on in the studio. I can, you know, have eye contact with Steve and with Manuel, the guys in the band, rather than having my head sort of buried in the sheet music. It's really nice to be in the music rather than in the music, if you know what I mean. Like, it actually in the music that's being played rather than the music that's on the sheet of paper. That's not to say you shouldn't work on your reading. Reading is a super useful skill if you're ever required to go in the studio. And some of this music is quite challenging as well. It's like music that the sheer volume of it, I think we have 18 or 20 songs on the list to record that won't all make it on the album. So that is a lot of material to learn. Some of it isn't fully arranged yet, so I can't, even if I wanted to, I couldn't even learn the songs because they're not laid out the way they will be in their final version on the album. But just the repetition of that material as much as I can in the days leading up to the session is a really good idea. Copy and paste that concept to touring or to just even a one-off gig as much time as you can commit ahead of the performance or the recording to learning that music, so you can get your head out of the sheet music, is really will give you a huge advantage. And also, to me, it gives me the advantage of being able to concentrate on what's working and what's not. I get to put my producer hat on a little bit, and I get to contribute to the situation in more ways than just playing my bass. I can sort of assess, you know, the good and the bad of what's happening in the studio and make suggestions when applicable. Be like, oh, you know what, maybe we could try like this, because I'm really zoomed out, you know, I'm in the macro rather than the micro, and I have I will have the ability to have a big picture view of what's going on. So yeah, I hope that helps you. If you're stuck in terms of what to practice, and maybe you have a few technical hitches or something, this is really hopefully something you have to think very little about, because a major scale is a familiar sound to you. Maybe you haven't played it in this exact combination notes before, so that could take a minute to get under the fingers. 12 keys, always the 12 keys, so important. And, you know, different areas of the instrument, same thing but an octave down, for instance, you know, just same octave but different position. All of those little things that you can push yourself to have a better understanding of the instrument, of the harmony, of the sound, of the feel. Anything you can do to enhance that, you're winning. And you can add so many things to such a short space of time that don't clutter what you're doing. It's not like you're trying to learn a song and play a bass line and play a solo and, you know, learn new harmony or something. These are all things that happen in a very simple exercise. You just have to start being aware of them. Time, sound, fluidity, consistency. We're not changing the notes. We're just making sure we concentrate on as much of the fundamentals as possible. All right, that's it. Good luck. Again, challenge yourself to do that every day, even if you've only got 5 minutes. Like me, I'm a newish dad. There's a crazy amount of stuff going on at home and work and, you know, the books and the bass studio and touring and studio. And my time is super limited. So sometimes as a professional bass player, I do only have 5 minutes a day to practice. I'm sure there are many people out there watching who are in the same boat for whatever reason, for a variety of reasons. But if you only have the 5 minutes, do it. Really discipline yourself to pick up the instrument. 5 minutes. It doesn't have to be this exercise, of course. This is just an idea. But whatever you choose, try and be consistent with it. Really important. Very last thing I'll say, because this is already too long, this video. Really important to record yourself doing it. And if you can record yourself every day, I know it's can be a pain in the ass. You don't have to do video, but just a little voice recorder in your smartphone. And hopefully you're going to notice some difference in your playing. Do this for a month and record yourself every day. And after that 30 days, 31 days, whatever, listen to the latest one and listen to the very first one, and I guarantee you are going to hear some differences in the tone, in the sound production, in your time, in your basic ability just to play whatever shape it is that you're playing. All right, that's it. I will catch you all on the next one. Don't forget to check out the new Substack, the new blog, which is packed full of stuff. And of course, if you're watching this around the time of shooting, it is our big yearly Black Friday sale. Again, get Bass 22. You can get 22% off all the bundles, all the albums, and all the individual books. And like I said in the ad earlier in this video, we've put together the entire book library for the first time in one bundle, and that is 50% off. So you can get the entire library for 50% off at janekgwizdala.com. All the books I've ever written, which come with over 500 play-alongs and videos. It's crazy. Go check it out. It's all linked in the description below. I'll see you guys again soon.